Now that we know the position of lights, let's place the lights. So open the tool palette and make a new palette here. And let's import the blocks we made in the previous video. So for that, I will have to use the command ADC, that is add center. So let's use the command ADC, and I will open the same drawing. I saved the drawing with the name of legend. So I will click on that file and I will import the blocks that I made in that drawing. So let's just select all of these and drag these in onto the tool palette, or the new palette that I have made here. So let's just drag and drop these on the palette. Now I won't have to open the ADC again and again. I can use all the tools and the blocks from here, the tool palette. Now let's just place the lights. And for placing the lights, I am going to make a new layer of lighting here, because the lighting and power is done in two separate steps, or is done in two separate files usually. So in this, we are doing it in the same file, but we are going to make two different layers for lighting and power. So I am going to make a new layer with the name of lights, and on that layer I will be placing my lights. So let's just drag and drop our lights and make sure that you're having the lights layer on. So you can see here what is the advantage of having a reflected ceiling plan. That is, I know the position, exact position of the lights, and I'm just going to drag and drop the lights over there. So all of these lights are the surface mounted lights, so there is no discrimination that I need to make here. But as for the suspended light and the light that is used in the laundry area, I will have to make discrimination, because I haven't made any symbol that is suitable for the suspended light or the light that is directional light there. So we are going to use the same symbol, but what I'm going to do is I am going to write something that is going to differentiate this. So I am denoting the suspended light with an R inside it. That's my own notation, and I will have to make a legend sheet in which I will have to specify that which symbol is for which thing. Now for this light, I am going to use this and an under cabinet light. I am joining these two together to make a directional light. Now I am going to remove this RCP from this file, so I am detaching the XREF. Up till here we have covered the lighting design, that is, we have not only did the lighting designing on DirectX Evo, but we have also marked the lighting positions in our AutoCAD drawings or floor plan. In the next videos we are going to cover the power portion, and that is it from this one.